Hi, welcome back to the smart board. In an earlier example, we looked at two layers, liquid A and B, with a component X dissolved in it. And we had as initial condition that there was twice as much of the concentration, this is the zero, of X in A than in B. And we knew that was given that in equilibrium the concentration of X in A is 30 times higher than that in B, as given here. We look at the same system, but now we try to understand, during the process of mass transfer from B to A, what can we say about the concentration profile in A or in B? Given is, for this case, that the mass transfer coefficients are not alike. In A, it's smaller than in B, differs by a factor of 5. So in order to understand how this initial concentration will shift over to the final concentration that we backed out in the earlier example, we're not going to solve the concentration, but we're going to see whether we can make a prediction about one of the two by looking at the resistances. So the question we need to answer is, where is the resistance to mass transfer sitting, giving M and giving these two mass transfer coefficients? To do so, we need to write down the expressions for the mass crossing the interface, phi double M, which is on the A side given by the transfer coefficient K sub A times the driving force on the A side, which is the value at the interface minus the value in the bulk. And I don't know what they are, but I can give them their names. All right, what did I write down? The driving force in A is nothing spectacular. It's the interface concentration minus the bulk concentration, as from the previous example we know that the transfer is from B to A. So concentration on the interface side here in the A phase is higher than in the B phase there, although I drew it in the other way. Similarly, that same flux is coming out of the B phase, where the coefficient for mass transfer is KB, the transfer coefficient, and now the driving force is in the bulk in B, it must be higher than at the interface in B, as now it moves from here to there. Okay, these two I didn't give a label, and that's for good reasons. The flow towards the interface from the B side must be the same as the flow into A from the interface, as an interface has no storage capacity. So these two are alike. The problem is that I have these two interface concentrations which bug me. I have no idea what they are, I only have the concentrations in the bulk. Okay, but I can get rid of them by using that at the interface, instantly on the scale of transport phenomena, these two obey the equilibrium relation. So I'm going to multiply the above equation by 1 over k A. That brings effectively that coefficient to the other side. And on this side, I multiply by M over k B. Why? That brings the KB away, but also makes that here M times the concentration in the B phase can be cancelled against 1 times the concentration in A on the interface. So if I've done this, multiplied by these, and now I add, so I add these two equations, then on the left hand side I get phi double M, and then between brackets 1 over k A on this side, KB times M is sitting here as well, and I need to add the two as I add the two equations, and on the other side KA is out, CAI is copied, minus CA in the bulk is copied, and then I add bulk B times M. And I subtract M C interface on the B side. Right? I just multiply what I did and add it. Okay? Now in equilibrium, this one vanishes against that one. Because this just states in equilibrium that the ratio is M and thus these two are zero. And now I get that the driving force here only contains the bulk values MCB bulk minus CA bulk. This is the driving force and this is the resistance. All right, but do we know about the resistance? This one has a value. Let me shift it slightly up. That is 1 over 2, 10 to the minus 5. And this one is 30 over 10 to the minus 4. So this gives me, on the A side, the resistance. That's half 10 to the minus, plus 5, which is 5, 10 to the power 4 in SI units. Whereas this one is going to be 30 times 10 to the power 4. Conclusion: the resistance on the B side is 6 times higher than on the A side. So if I draw the profiles, the concentration profiles, I know that at any moment in time there is hardly any resistance on the A side. All resistance is more or less on the B side, so the A side can't have a very high concentration gradient. It's more or less straight, not exactly straight, because it has to flow in that direction, but more or less the, whereas the B side has all the resistance, so it must do something like this. I don't know what, but something like this. Here is a big step, because there's a high concentration, so you need a strong driving force. Here is a very small driving force on the A side. Concentration in that direction. No, in that direction. Concentration drop in the A side is very small because there's hardly any resistance, so it flows very fast. On the B side, there's lots of resistance, so it must have a high concentration drop.